Today we're talking about 15 practical things you can do with an old computer. Let's jump right into it. Number 1. Working with the hardware. Old computers are great for learning the basics of disassembly and reassembly. Sure, modern parts look a little bit different, but they're still recognizable. It's a great way to learn how computers work and how the parts interact with each other, without running the risk of damaging something of high value. If you've only ever purchased pre-built computers, it can be a lot of fun taking a computer apart and putting it back together again. You may even be inspired to build your next PC from parts. Number 2. Learning how to solder. Old computers require maintenance. One such task is a process called recapping, which is basically replacing capacitors. This is a great way to practice soldering skills by working on computer components that are not of any particular value. I should preface numbers 1 and 2 by saying old computers refers to the Pentium 4 era and forward, as some systems that are older can have a lot of value or be very rare. Number 3. Experiment. If you're a lifelong Windows user, having an extra computer is the perfect opportunity to familiarize yourself with Linux. You may even be surprised at how smoothly Linux runs on an old machine. The reason is that Linux demands much less processing power. Alternatively, if you are feeling ambitious, you could try your hand at making a Hackintosh. For those not familiar with the term, Hackintosh refers to a computer that runs an Apple Macintosh operating system on hardware not authorized by Apple. You could even try multi-booting various versions and combinations of Windows, Mac, and Linux. You might also want to try creating your own version of a Chromebook or Chromebox, which is essentially Google Chrome as the entire operating system. Number 4. Storage and file sharing. Turn your old computer into a home server or network-attached storage. Either way you go, these options allow you to store files and share them on your local network or over the internet. Sure, Google probably has all your personal data, photos, your resume, every letter you've ever written on your computer, etc. But not all of the data Google collects on you can be accessed. For the data you can access, it's not always guaranteed or free. Google has recently made policy changes, capping free storage at 15 gigabytes. So if you rely heavily on Google services, you will be forced to pay for them soon. Number 5. Various server roles. Repurpose your old computer as one of many different types of servers. Some options include media server, file server, web server, email server, or dedicated game server. In the same vein as a home server, you can use your old computer to host your own website, email accounts, files, media, or a private game server. There's no need to stop there, as there are so many server roles old computers can fill. Depending on the configuration, the server doesn't need to have a lot of processing power. The heavy lifting is done by the client workstations. Number 6. Set up an external firewall or router. Traditionally, old computers are either not connected to the internet or separated from the rest of the computers on the network because they pose a security risk. However, an old computer can be put between the internet and your other systems by assuming the role of a firewall or router. There are many benefits to doing this, some of which include additional security and parental controls. Number 7. Use it for retro gaming. This option seems obvious and self-explanatory. Older PCs can generally handle older games, and there are plenty of ports of old titles that work on PC. You can turn an older PC into a dedicated gaming system. Steam and GOG have an excellent selection of older titles. You can even go the emulation route. Connect your old computer to a TV and set it up for console gaming. Number 8. Build your own TiVo or slingbox. Why should we have to pay a monthly fee to record a TV show we are already paying for to watch? Put your old computer to work by adding a TV tuner and setting it up to record TV in place of a DVR you rent from your cable company. You can take that one step further by configuring your old computer to also stream TV to other devices, even when you're outside your home. Traveling on a business trip and not wanting to flip through dozens of channels to find something interesting to watch? Stream your favorite shows either live or pre-recorded from your DVR PC. Number 9. Build your own arcade cabinet. You can build your own arcade machine for use in your home. The cabinet is a DIY project in and of itself. After the effort of assembling your own cabinet, why have it only play a single game, when you can use an old PC to power the arcade machine and allow you to access entire libraries of arcade games? Number 10. Make it a guest room or kitchen PC. If you have a guest in your home and they need a computer for simple tasks like looking something up on the internet, you can have an old PC available for them to use. Old PCs are also great to have in the kitchen for use as a digital cookbook of sorts. Sure, you may have a cookbook or recipes that have been handwritten or printed, but you may be looking for something that's not in your existing catalog of recipes. In comes an old PC, allowing you to quickly look up new recipes without having to leave the kitchen. You could also keep an inventory of what's in the fridge and pantry, along with using tools like SuperCook that tell you what you can make with the ingredients you have on hand. Number 11. Surveillance system. Popular options for smart home security share a problem: a monthly subscription fee. The fee is often charged per camera, which can add up. An old computer offers an old-school alternative. Instead of connecting cameras to the cloud, you can connect them to your locally hosted computer. This avoids a monthly fee, no matter how many cameras you connect. A locally hosted solution also avoids the privacy concerns some users might have about cloud-based home security. Number 12. A kid's first computer. Depending on the age, some old computers can still perform functions like word processing, basic web browsing, and email. They are also great for old games. This makes them great for a kid's first computer. While old computers may not be powerful enough for Fortnite, they can do the essentials and provide some entertainment. Number 13. Set up a live weather station. This option is very niche and fun for weather enthusiasts. You don't have to live in Tornado Alley to be a weather geek. If you love the weather, try setting up your very own weather tracking center on an old PC. You can do this by installing weather software like StormLab and leave your computer running. If you capture anything awesome, you can even share it with your local news station. Number 14. Sell it for parts or as a complete system. Somewhere on the internet, someone is looking for a computer. They may not be able to afford a new PC or are looking for a second PC for the family. Your old PC at the right price may be just what they need. Assuming everything goes smoothly, everyone wins. You unload your old hardware, which finds a good home with a new user that can appreciate it. Number 15. Donate. This is a very broad category. An old computer is better than no computer. Making an old computer the perfect thing to hand down to a sibling, donate to a relative, or donate for use in places around the world where people don't have the resources to buy or use modern computers. Especially in education, old computers still have a use today. Other options include offering old computers to your favorite tech YouTuber, donating it to a thrift store, or you can donate your old computer to science. There are various distributed computing projects where software ties together a huge number of internet-connected PCs to work on computationally massive problems. For example, there is the Folding at Home crowdsourcing project, which can be set up to help researchers fight the novel coronavirus causing COVID-19. Set it up on an old PC and let the software run in the background. There are many art-related projects that use old computers. However, I'm of the opinion that old technology should be preserved, not destroyed. That is why those options have been omitted from this list. In conclusion, there are so many fun and interesting things you can do with an old computer. Don't take it to the recycler just yet. Thanks for stopping by. See you next video.